I am sought of them that asked not for me. I am found of them that sought not me not. I said, behold me, behold me. And to a nation that was not called by my name. Let's do a new game. And Spore is kind of a game about evolution. And yeah, science. Thinks and the school education thinks that evolution is fact, but in a way it's not. Evolution, the theory, I mean, everyone knows about it. Suddenly there were microorganisms and they mutated into greater beings, and so on and so forth, and suddenly there was something bigger, and yeah, that's not how it was. No matter how many think that it is so, but evolution stays a theory. Exactly like the Big Bang. No one was there when the Big Bang was. Everybody says, but who was there when God made the Earth? Or he shaped it new, you know? No one was there when there was the Big Bang. But everyone says like, yeah, but it's proven. It's science. You know? Big Bang was never written about in ancient times, and it's still a theory. And that's the truth, no? Doesn't matter if people like the idea of evolution. It's not about what you like, it's not about make you happy or shaping your own worlds. No, it's about how reality really is, not how you want reality to be. It's not what is about. Life is not about you, not about me. It's about God and his creation, and we are here because of him, and we're not here to fulfill, you know, live for ourselves. We're here to live for God and love God, live for him, you know? And the thing is, since the sin fall, it's, you know, that's, oha. Since sin, we were born in rebellion, all of us, and we're appointed to die once and then get judged by God. And in these times, most people don't like the idea to have a God that created everything, you know? And there are many counter-religions. Many counter-religions. But no, many people ask why is Christianity the one religion? You know, it's not about Christianity, it's about God and the Bible. Many Christian religions don't even take the Bible serious, because many of them have adopted in the modern times where it's officially insane to believe what the Bible says, that demons don't exist, that, you know, today we are so educated, we're so wise, know everything, so on. And this can be true, but it isn't. Doesn't matter if you like it or not. Evolution is just material. So, because, you know, in this game, there's the story, there are little water beings that are getting bigger and bigger. The more they eat, they mutate. And, you know, always have that cute eyes and so on. And, you know, it seems very, very legit to believe that evolution exists, but it's impossible because there never was a case of real evolution. The only thing we have proven is microevolution, and that's adaptation in a species to certain environment situations, where the mouth may be longer, or interbreeding and so on, but that's not evolution. It's not. And if you look at evolution theory, first there has to be nothing, and then out of something in the Big Bang, everything was somehow created. And then after, somehow microorganisms came to life out of non-living material. Then the microorganisms mutated. And that's not possible in our world. No. In our system, no matrix, no matter how you call it, it's just not possible, because everything, every little cell, even in our body, can't mutate and survive, because every cell has a construction plan, and when this cell mutates, the construction plan doesn't fit with the actual construction, the cell dies. And these mutated cells that are differing from the initial the initial structure, these cells will be die. And there is no way that these cells somehow mutate without dying. And that's why evolution can't work the way they say it does. Also, if you take, if evolution would exist, if we were made by chance, this computer game also could have been made by chance. And impossible to make a computer game by chance. Make a random generator and let him program an 0 and 1 random and wait till Spore comes out. It won't happen. It's because it's impossible to make a computer game by chance. It's impossible. And it's also impossible to have evolution happen by chance, because our bodies are more and more complex than this video game. And even one cell is probably more complex than this video game. So, the evolution theory is very, 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 very hard to prove. Even when everyone in the education system and so on tells that kids it's proven and so on, but no, it's just not really proven. It's just they want to think that evolution exists, because they don't want to admit that there is a god they have to give account to after they die. Many, many people today seem to deny God's existence because they don't like the idea that a creator exists. But look at game engines, especially the Source engine. There's also religions where a god source, a little, there's the world seen as created by an unpersonal creation force that is called the Force or Source or something, and that we are just you know, created by spiritual you said spiritual rules. These rules make up everything and so on, like in Star Wars, the Force that created everything and so on. And we can just do whatever we want, we can use this force how we want, and it's just, you know, just about the balance between light and darkness and so on. But, God clearly states that he is light, there's no darkness in him. And that's very contradicting to modern philosophies about like in the light and darkness. Of course, we don't know other worlds or other principles, because in our world there's light, there's darkness, and that's how it is. It is, but you can't just say because you don't see it, it's not there. It's not how it works. That, no, that's not how reality is created. And man, even if you don't believe in God, even the possibility of going to hell should make you think about it twice before you deny God. I know that's it seems like, you know, you only believe in God because of fear and so on, but you know, make your own research on it, on these things. You will see that many many things in this world are not like we're told. But you need to seek the real truth, not try to explain it all away as coincidence or something, but you know, just search for the truth, no matter what it is, no matter how hard it will be to grasp. It's better to know the truth and get frightened, maybe. Still, if you know the truth, you can act on it. But the sad thing of today's society, we have education and so on. We think we know so much, but many theories, many things we learn are not how they are. We learn about religions that they are just because of people that had not functional brains and they were crazy and so on, and that's why there were religions, and religions were just for the weak-minded people and so on. But truth is, true religion of God, of the real God, there is only one God, and this God sent his son Jesus Christ, the Word of God, to die for our sins. And these people who stood for the truth, the true religion of God, they were persecuted all the time. Maybe they had short timelines where they were not that much persecuted, but there was no cell. There were always weird people to many. That's something you should think about, you know? Why should still people today worship God? You know, if everyone is so educated and can explain him away, you know? Evolution tells us that death is necessary for natural selection. So like here, one the stronger eats the weaker and so on. I mean, it's the explanation out of coincidence. There was this world, and that world, out of coincidence, was because of natural selection, and so on. Coincidence. I mean, every species found till now was, is, fully developed. There are not no half developed in betweens. The only things that are in betweens were fake. There are many fake bones of supposedly missing links. Of course, many say, yeah, there are many, many missing links and so on, but there are none. The only missing links you got are some things, some bones or something that are not really, no one is really sure where they came from. They could be just some bones from a few species thrown together. It's not, it's not really proof anything. But people want to believe in evolution, although they mock creation, but evolution, that is ridiculous if you think about it, and not proven. Many people want to believe that, because seemingly for many people it's uncomfortable to think about the Creator having created the universe for this world, because it doesn't matter if the universe, how our science thinks it exists, really exists, because because it never really affected us that much. All we see from our eyes when we zoom on them, the stars are lights. They're just lights for us. The whole images of these planets and universes and so on, as much as I know, are simply computer generated images. Nothing more, nothing less. And again, it proves nothing. Many things, people were in space and so on. Many videos they made from NASA and so on can be proven as fake. They have lots of tricks they can use. I mean, the most of the NASA footage is not even close to the Avatar movie and other sci-fi films. I mean, the official Hollywood films are better than the NASA videos. Which is very sad, honestly, because they fake it so bad, and still it doesn't make a difference. People still believe it. Yeah, there we have it. Yay! Basically, this game is a game about the unproven theory that's most likely a lie. Yeah, that's about it. It's not. Hitler said once, if you repeat a lie long enough, it becomes the truth. And today, we have many lies repeated over and over again and said it's proven. But the people that say it's proven, they never come with the proof. They just say it's proven. And that's enough for them. But it shouldn't be for you, not your life is at stake. If your life depends on having the right information, then you should think about the afterlife, about God, about many things. Because God exists, whether you want to believe it or not. God doesn't disappear because you believe in evolution. God. Whoa. I mean, it that's okay. Most people believe in evolution. But I have to say that it's a lie. That's the truth. But everyone has a responsibility to search for the truth. Most people do think that they are can be fed by the government, by the parents with the truth. No, and they don't have to do anything, and they just have the truth since the beginning. The truth is that many people are deceived in this century of knowledge, and they would never think about thinking about that this knowledge that they are told is the truth. Maybe far from the truth, and even deceiving them into going into their own grave. How many people believe that after they die, that it's over and they don't have to do anything anymore? It doesn't matter if they're greedy or they're lustful and so on. It doesn't matter. No. It's just, it's okay to do that, many things so, because there's no one will judge them, nothing will happen, because that many people will. Go, only live for money, for your career, and mock those people that are living for God. And most people think, oh, there's nothing wrong with that, huh? That they can do that without consequences. But I tell you, it's not so. The consequences come after death. There you will be rewarded with what you did in this life. Most people are going to hell. It's not a nice thing. Not at all. But poisonous monkeys. I mean, it was very cute. I love these small things, but it's dangerous to deny God, honestly. So, I mean, so. Oh, I'm just learning. What is that? Okay. Let's go. There. Hello. Oh. They're dancing. Ooh. They have so much charm. Oh my god. Oh. But they can see. Can they? Yeah. Oh. Oh. Why are they dancing? Oh. Oh, so sad. One-eyed creature. It's amazing. Really amazing. But ye are they that forsake the Lord, that forget my holy mountain, that prepare a table for the troop, and that furnish the drink of name offering unto that number. Man, many people ask about why is the Old Testament and the New Testament are so different and so on, but God didn't change in the Old and the New Testament. Look at Revelations. God is love, but is still a judge, and he judges the nations in Revelation. Only because also Jesus wasn't non-judging. He judged sin. He forsaken sin. It wasn't. Whoa. It wasn't accepted by him. Whoa. He died for our sin. Without him we couldn't be here. And he was the lamb that was sacrificed for us. In the Old Testament, the Israelites had to sacrifice a 3-year-old lamb. Spotless lamb for their sins, and Jesus Christ was the spotless lamb. To rid us from our sins, we just believe in him, give our life to him, and think here it will end. Behold, my servants shall sing for joy of heart, but ye shall cry for sorrow of heart, and shall howl for vexation of spirit. The thing is, if you screw up in this life and die, didn't make the decision for Christ, it will be a rough awakening. Let's say that. Because of that, I would recommend to give your life to Jesus Christ and live for him from this day on till the end of your life. Don't take the oath at each other. And pray, God, please forgive me. Jesus, please be my Lord and Savior. Please help me to avoid sin, live for you. Thank you that you died on the cross for me, that I didn't have to go to hell. And thank you, Lord. Amen. God bless. Hallelujah.